Hello everyone, my name is Stephen George and I play video games. Today, it's a demo. Every Friday on Stephen Plays, we do Demo Fridays, where we try a new demo. Today's demo is Worms 2 Armageddon, which sounds really odd to me because I'm more familiar with the title known as Worms Armageddon. This is not the same game. Team 17 rebranded the Worms games. Because there was, you know, Worms, then Worms 2, then Worms Armageddon, then Worms World Party. And then somewhere along the line, they were like, oh, we got too many titles. Let's go back to just Worms. So then they were just Worms again. Now this is Worms 2 Armageddon. So you can see how I'm really confused. Because there was Worms Armageddon. Now it's Worms 2 Armageddon, which is a completely different game. Even though all the Worms games are the same. Anyway, I'm a huge, huge fan of Worms. The series is kind of, I want to say, went downhill over the past few years, but it's not really that it went downhill, it's just it never changed. They kept releasing the same game over and over and over again. They weren't doing a whole lot to expand the series. But if you've never played Worms, it's going to be fresh. Let's start by going down to the options. Let's see, look at how to play. An overview. Worms is turn-based, blah, 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 blah. Zoom in using that, zoom out, okay? Because knowing the buttons is like a huge part of Worms. If you don't know how to do all the buttons, and there's like a million buttons, then you're screwed. So we use the control pad to move. X jumps, XX is backflip, okay. Select a weapon to fire, open the weapon panel, which is B. Simply selecting the one you desire and confirm by pressing A to set up a shot. Use point direction, fire by pressing A, so A is shoot. Okay, got it. Teams, game styles, artificial intelligence, single player, weapons, dear god, utility. So it actually shows you very in-depth how to play the game. Controls would be good. So toggle the fuse, weapons panel, fire select, jump, move worm. Looks like they've actually simplified the controls a little over the years too. I had Worms Armageddon on Nintendo 64. Fantastic game. Such a fantastic game. Really hard to come by now too. Really hard to find Worms Armageddon for the N64. It's also on the PlayStation and PC. Probably best on PC. I think we're going to be good otherwise. So let's just jump into a single-player match. This is a trial game and such, achievements, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Quick game, training, campaign. I can do a quick game. I think I could hold my own. Hopefully. I don't know. It's been a while since I've played Worms, but I think I'll do all right.
Say hi, because hello is complicated enough.
Okay, so if you've never played the Worms titles, the Worms are funny. They're very funny people. They talk. And
say hi, because hello is complicated enough.
They apparently also repeat themselves. Also, it looks like the game gave me a handicap, which is really odd. I don't feel like I need the handicap, but whatever. So we've got the bazooka, which is the default weapon, heavily affected by the wind. Grenades, ninja rope, which kind of an expert thing, and it's been a while since I played this game, so I don't know if I'm going to be all that great at it. Let's start with the bazooka. The bazooka should, if nothing's changed, be able to do a solid 50 points of damage. Although what we really want to do is knock that worm into the water, because that'll kill him instantly.
Fire! Burning things since the dawn of time.
Okay, it did not knock him in the water, which I was
next time, you're mine.
Really hoping for. Did 38 damage, so this worm, Traffic, has only got 12 left.
First blood, rated 15 at movie theaters near you.
What the?
Got an unwanted.
What the piss was that?
Flyfly.com.
Was that
times when you just want to go away?
Was that his turn, or was that?
Say hi.
That must have been their.
Hello is complicated enough.
Must have been his turn. What the crap was that? Was that an airstrike of some sort? It must be over here. A bunker buster. Okay, so that's a weapon I was not aware of. So there's all kinds of stuff. Dragon Ball. I'm familiar with most of these. The Holy Hanger. Dear God, that would do them in. I'm gonna see if I can use this successfully. Because I gotta put just enough throw on it where it doesn't go in the water over there, but jumps over that little taxi. So hopefully I don't screw this up too bad.
Kaboom grenades! The only grenades worth showing out for!
That sucks. Oh wow. Yeah, you're screwed. So Burger's totally friggin' dead.
How refreshing.
110 damage. And I almost knocked Taxi off right there too. This is such a fun game. It's actually a lot of fun with a lot of people as well.
You had it coming. Fatality.
Okay, so he knocked Grant into the water, which kills him instantly. I still got 3 worms left, and they gave me a handicap for some reason, so I'm not too worried. An easy kill would just be Yeah, I think the easiest kill here would just be using the bazooka and blowing out the land right under Taxi. Also, I freaking love this game. I know I haven't... I don't think I've really ever talked about it too much, but doggone, I freaking love Worms. I would be definitely okay with doing a full-length LP at some point because it's magnificently good game. Okay, so we could do a Fire Punch, which is classy. We could do that. Not that. It's a Dragon Ball. I don't know if it'll make it all the way over there.
Is never enough.
Is that too far away? Let's go for it.
Fire Punch, made from real dragon scales, for a smoking punch.
Okay, they've changed that because the Dragon Ball used to fly forward. Oof. That sucks. Okay, so I kind of wasted a turn. Ooh, a parachute. Okay, that was the dumbest friggin' thing I ever saw.
Firearms from Wormington.
You just killed yourself. Is that the... Okay, there's still one guy up there. I can take care of him.
Hello is complicated enough.
Thank you for repeating yourself. I can take care of that guy over there pretty quickly and easily. If I want to get really complicated, I can try and use my ninja rope. Because that was... Whenever I played Worms back in the day with people, it has a really high learning curve. And one of the hardest things for people to get a hold of was wrapping their head around the ninja rope and how it worked. I'm going to try and relive some of my N64 days and see if it works the same way. I still got it. I still totally got it, which is awesome. Okay, let's come down here and now we can actually equip that fire punch, which is going to send him upwards and hopefully down into the drink.
Worm Duke and Dragon Ball.
Oh, fart. Oh. Well, now he's down there with him instead. Okay. That still totally works. It does a solid 30 damage if it hits.
Cooey, what's this? What the?
Someone doesn't want to live anymore. Ow. Now, when he dies, they're actually going to blow themselves up.
Oof.
So that he's banking on the fact that he'll take out Jason. But he wasn't close enough. So Jason lives to see another day. The only worm left is Traffic. And that sucks for him, because he's real easy to take out. At this point, it's just deciding the most creative way to take him out. I could really just play with my food, which would be kind of fun. The pneumatic drill, ooh, that'd be fun. Let's give this parachute thing a shot. Oh, the wind. That's right, the wind. Kids, in the bottom left corner, you'll see the wind meter, which is very useful when using something like the parachute. Let's see here. Blowtorch? Airstrike? Airstrikes are fun. Do I have any other major weapons coming? It doesn't look... Oh, a friggin' banana bomb. Friggin' banana bomb. I love these things. Check this out.
Fire! Burning things is the dawn of time.
Banana bombs are friggin' dangerous. They will mess you up. Good show. Anyway, Traffic, you can go ahead. I'm just having fun blowing everything up.
Every time.
Airstrike. Pretty good, pretty good. Not hitting Jason. And doing 40 damage to Pix. And it looks like it's going to be... Who's turn? Jason.
Say hi, because hello is complicated enough.
So let's jump up here. Backflip. Woo! And, okay. I think it's time to end this little soiree. Shotgun. Goodbye.
Worms. At your H2Go, the only water worth drowning. Victory, the winner's choice.
And we're doing some nice little wormy hip thrusts, which is pretty awesome. So we won the round there. And normally you choose how many rounds you want to do. You can do 3 or 5 or 7 or 9 or whatever. I don't know what this particular game is like, but in the previous Worms titles, there's a full campaign and there's actual missions and stuff you have to do. It's also super, super fun multiplayer. Some of the most fun I've ever had was playing Worms. You have to play with competent people. It's the only problem. You have to find people who are good at Worms. Because, like I said, the learning curve is really high. It takes a while to get used to it. But I would definitely recommend checking out the Worms series if you've never checked it out before. One of my favorite games. Anyway, if you enjoyed this episode in any capacity, please click like. If you haven't done so already, highly consider subscribing to Steven Plays. New video game episode every single day, a new demo every Friday. And along those lines, make sure you recommend a demo for me to play in the comments below. So once again, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys here next week for Steven Plays Demo Fridays.